Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel, and we are bringing our lecture number 101, which is focused on the process flow sheeting, and we are bringing the production of n-octane using Aspen HYSYS as our today's topic. So if you have not subscribed yet, please do subscribe the channel and click the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. So this is the overall schematic diagram of the production of n-octane, and this process starts from this point number one, which is the feed. And initially, we will obviously give the feed without recycle system into this reactor, and this reactor is provided the external heat as well. This reactor is an isothermal reactor. It means feed temperature and the product temperature will remain the same. Conversion reactor will take place in this reactor. Then the separation process takes place, and in this column, the stream number 4 and stream number 5 are produced. The stream number 4 is further split into two parts, 6 and 7. This is a purge stream. And this stream is recycled. And how it is recycled? First, it is compressed, then it is cooled down to the temperature as that of the feed temperature, and then is recycled. And this mixer provides a junction or a part for the recycling process, that this feed is mixed with the recycled one, and then the total stream is entering this reactor. And the number 3 and number 5 are our product streams, which contain high purity n-octane, and we will see it once we will be doing the simulation process. So the components and property package which are involved in this simulation exercise are ethylene, n-butane, iso-butane, n-octane and nitrogen, and the property package which we will be using is Prang-Robinson. The feed specifications: the temperature of the feed is 93 degrees centigrade, the pressure is 20 psia, and the molar flow rates of each component is given, that ethylene is 20 kg mol per hour, 0.5 for n-butane, 10 for i-butane and 0.1 for nitrogen. For the reaction, 2 moles of ethylene reacts with 1 mole of isobutane to form 1 mole of normal octane, and we are assuming 98% conversion of ethylene in this process because we are using a conversion reactor. Pressure drop of 7 psi in the reactor. And this is an isothermal reactor, as I have already told you in the description. In the distillation column, top product phase is vapor. Light key in bottoms, we have already discussed in our previous videos. I will give its link in the description as well. Light key in bottoms, ethylene 0.0015. Heavy key in distillate and octane 0.28. Pressure of condenser is 15 psia. Pressure of reboiler is 25 psia. Accordingly, based on these parameters, we will get a value of minimum flux ratio, and we will compute, or we will specify, external reflux ratio over there. Then in T, split ratio of purge and product, or the recycle one, purge is 0.1, while the product or recycle one is 0.9. Obviously, we want maximum quantity to be recycled and minimum quantity to be purged. And the compressor outlet pressure is 22 psia. For the cooler, the pressure drop is 0 psia, and the outlet temperature is 93 degrees centigrade, which is same as that of the feed specification. So let's go to the Aspen HYSYS and, using all these parameters, simulate the n-octane production process. So first we will add the components. Our components are ethylene, n-butane, i-butane, n-octane and nitrogen. So these are the 5 components which are included in this process, and the fluid package to be selected is Prang-Robinson. After that, we know that the conversion reactor is specified, so add reaction, clicking on this conversion, and then we know that ethylene, isobutane and n-octane. Stoichiometric coefficient for ethylene is minus 2, for isobutane minus 1, and for n-octane it is 1, and the balance error is 0. It means we have specified it correctly, and the conversion is 98%. Adding it to fluid package. We have already done this part one by one, step by step, in our previous exercise. Going to simulation environment, and we have to first add the reactor. And this one is the conversion reactor. And quickly, we will do the connections. But before that, we will install a mixer over here to accommodate for the recycling process. Now the feed stream will be given to this mixer. And we will specify it as 1 is its inlet, which is feed, and 11 its outlet. And the given conditions are 93 degrees centigrade, 20 psia, and we will double click on it, and we will specify the mole flows. And what are these mole flows? 20 kg mole for ethylene, 0.5 for normal butane, 10 for isobutane, and 0.1 kg mole per hour for nitrogen. So clicking on OK, and this block is converged. Now we will send this stream to the reactor, and installing this mixer ahead or at the start is good idea. Otherwise, you need to do some modifications at the end. Vapor outlet is 2, liquid outlet is 3, and we will specify a heat over here, which is Q100. Now it requires a reaction set, and set number 1 is specified. Unknown duty, we do not know the duty, but we know reactor is isothermal in nature. The temperature will be 93 degrees centigrade. However, we have missed one parameter, that is to specify the pressure drop, and that is delta P, which is 7 psi. So this pressure drop is specified, and you can see now that the given conditions are now achieved. After that, we will use shortcut distillation column, which is placed over here, and quickly doing the connections over here. 2 is its inlet, Q101 for condenser duty, Q102 for reboiler duty, 4 number is the distillate stream, and 5 number is the bottom stream. And the top product phase is vapor. Parameters, the light key in bottoms is ethylene, and heavy key in distillate is n-octane as given in the problem statement. And this value, mole fraction is 0.0015. For this, it is 0.28. The condenser pressure is 15 psia. The reboiler pressure is 25 psia. And we have been given this 0.243 as minimal flux ratio, which is computed by Aspen HYSYS. We will specify, obviously, the higher value than this. So let's specify external flux ratio as a value of 1. And accordingly, we will get in performance value that the minimum number of trays are 2. Actual number of trays 3, optimal feed stage obviously it will be 1, and accordingly these values are calculated. If you specify the smaller value, obviously you can specify, but again we want minimum number of trays in this process. Now this number 5 and number 3 are our product streams, and if we clicking on here, it is 97.57% pure n-octane, and this one is 97.6% pure n-octane. Now we need to recycle this number 4, because if we look at this number 4 in the composition, it is a mixture of ethylene, n-butane, i-butane, n-octane and nitrogen. So instead of wasting it, let's recycle it. So first we need to install a T over here and quickly rotating it to adjust it accordingly. And in this T, 4 is the inlet, 6 and 7 are the outlet. 7-1 is the purge stream, while 6 is our recycle. So recycle 1 is 0.9 and it is converged. And now this one is to recycle, but for this we need to install a compressor over here. So again, installing a compressor and rotating it. And 6 is its inlet, 8 is its outlet, and Q103 is its duty. So accordingly, going to this worksheet, 22 psia is its outlet pressure, as we have seen in the problem statement. So accordingly, this one we need to rotate it as well so that we get the connections right. Now we need to cool it down to the same temperature as that of the feed. So 8 is its inlet, 9 as outlet, Q104 energy stream, there is no delta P. So accordingly, we can specify, going to design in parameters, delta P as 0, and accordingly this one as 93 degrees centigrade. So this one is created over here, and we can rotate it as well to ensure that there is a uniformity in the connection system. So this one is the overall schematic before the recycling process. Now we need to recycle it. So what we need to do, click on recycle, place it over here. 9 will be its inlet, 10 will be its outlet, and it will be converged. There is no issue in it. However, the issue may arise when we connect this number 10 with this mixer. So let's do it, and it will complete the recycling part. Till now, there is no recycle in the system. We have labeled number 10 as our recycle stream, but obviously once we connect it with mixer, it will actually be recycled. So clicking and placing with number 10, and you can see there is a warning that the recycle has reached iterations limit without converging. So what we need to do, we need to click on this recycle and click on this continue, and it has now converged. So this is the overall schematic of n-octane production in Aspen HYSYS, and we have seen it without recycle and with recycle process. Without recycle process, it was till this point when the stream was not connected to the mixer, but now it is connected. So it is fresh stream, which is 30.6 kg mole per hour, and the recycled stream, which is 4.319 kg mole per hour. And then the mixed stream is then sent to this reactor. Now you can see this one is at 89.89 degrees centigrade. This one is at 93 degrees centigrade. So what we need to do, obviously we have seen that this is a isothermal reactor. So we will delete this parameter and we will install our mathematical logical operations, which is set, and we will place it over here. Now double clicking on it, what is our target variable? Our target variable is that we want the value of temperature of stream number 2 same as that of stream number 11. So this one temperature, select it, and then source is 11. So accordingly you can see the temperatures will remain the same. So this temperature and this temperature are now similar. Obviously there will be some deviation in the conditions, because earlier this temperature was 93, now it is 90.05, and that is dictated by this 11. So these set adjust tools are very helpful if you use it these correctly, and these ease your work. Otherwise you need to manually check and adjust these accordingly every time. So that's how the overall simulation process is completed. And again, the number 3 and number 5 are our product streams of n-octane, and accordingly we can do manipulations to adjust the purities, and accordingly we can proceed. Like we can decrease the mole purity over here, and we can increase the conversion parameter over here as well. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.